Alright, I am here. Alright, I just have one more thing to check before I get totally settled in. Nothing overly. I just want to make sure that the volume is all good on the background music. Do let me know if that needs to be adjusted, because for now, I have it on a certain volume for me that is a little bit lower, so that it's not overly distracting. I do apologize if I seem a little bit distracted. I just had an important phone call that I needed to take, in terms of stuff happening offline. I am absolutely ready to paint. And with that, I think I can hop into the live scene here. I have been working on other pieces. Hello. Oh, before I do that, oh, can't believe I almost forgot. If you have stuff that you are working on while we hang out here, absolutely feel free to share in the chat what that is if you would like to. If there's any adjustments that need to be made in terms of volume with me or the music or the background music, stuff like that, let me know. I am absolutely trying to make sure that I balance that stuff out right, and make sure that you are having snacks on hand, drinks, that you're hydrating, taking care of yourself, your body, stretching as needed if you are painting alongside me. Do not want to have to worry about that. But without further ado, I think I can start pulling up settings, layers, two things that I'm working on. Okay, so with this piece, we are all that is left, as you can see, is the costume bits of this piece. We've finished the carpeting of the floor. We've finished the wall shading, and all of that. So all that's left, all the hair, the hats, all that is left is the actual costume. And we're gonna start with Henry's costume. To shade. I do apologize for hearing all the sniffles, by the way. I have no clue what's happening. Alright, we're gonna move. For me, I'm just gonna very quickly move the settings. And then find the right shade to blend with. Alright. Now, I have started putting the shading at 75 for opacity. Just to make sure that we are in fact getting what we need to be doing. Alright, yeah, that is definitely dark enough to see the difference. But I think I can probably go a little bit lighter. What are we thinking? There we go. That makes it a little bit more subtle, which I will take. I am so happy and excited right now. Don't mind me. I am currently sort of still trying to figure out going forward what to have for background music. So if this is putting you to sleep, that sort of thing, absolutely let me know, because until I can afford to stream video games that have its own like engaging stuff in it, that is not what I want, and this is what I have to work with. So, I have to try to figure out what to pick for that sort of thing. And I might need your opinions, as I'm gonna need your opinions as the viewers, as to what that is. How has everyone's day been, by the way? I have been absolutely looking forward to, like I said, I just had an important life stuff thing that I had to manage, and that being a job interview, which I am looking forward to. Something that I'm not a position. I'm not obviously not going to say much on the chance that I get it, but it's one that I'm actually pretty confident that I'm in a position to be able to navigate pretty well. Which cannot be said for a lot, sometimes, in terms of my skill sets. And I am going to get, I don't have a lot of work experience, in terms of, like, physical locations, since I hopped into it, during just before the panini happened. So I'm really kind of relying on, a good resume and a good interview, which I would like to think I'm pretty good with people. I'm pretty good at, knowing what to say. Okay. And then, was it this 12? And then we're going to bring that down to 50. Just to make sure we're getting some gradients here. There we go. There we go. Okay. Now we're moving along. Yeah, so how is everyone else's day? Had a pretty good weekend. I did some work on another piece that I was really happy with how it came out with. I was using a random generator, random character generator, that was suggested to me by my girlfriend, who is an incredible artist, who I'm super proud of. She's starting to get, like, a lot of stuff happening art-wise. She introduced me to this site called Random Generator, and it suggested, I find it entertaining, mostly because, I did not realize what it reminded me of until I was painting it, but it reminded me of a Venonat. It reminded me of a Venonat, like the Pokemon. But, like, if it were a person, which I found interesting, and fascinating to do as a concept. It was fun, though. I sort of took, some inspiration from the way my girlfriend does pieces. She will take a figure, and then do three different poses with it, three different perspectives to shade from, and it's always comes out looking gorgeous, like gorgeous, and it's, yeah, I just am so freaking lucky to date an artist like that. Hopefully, one day, and I know one day we're gonna see it, her work is gonna be in stores. There's just no way that it's not. So, yeah, I mean, I'm just... So, I pulled inspiration from that, and I, ended up making, like, the three figures, and it looked really, really good. As far as I'm concerned, and I'm really happy with how it came out. So, absolutely there. I will probably show it at the end of stream if you remind me. So I'm really happy with how that came out, and I want to definitely show off my work there. There we go. Okay. Now I'm actually going to up the blending on this, just because this is very blended. Very, very blended. Or at least it's supposed to be very, very blended, at least, of course. There we go. Alright. And now we clean this up. And then I might put the pants on a separate layer and then shade it as I would a piece normally. otherwise, I don't know that it makes much sense. And the shading will blend into each other in a way that is not very appealing. So we're going to make sure to try to be mindful of that. Okay. I have the sidebar next to me. Lower level, of course, but you know, there. There we go. How about everyone's enjoying their day so far? Clearly I am. I'm in a very good mood. I'm currently sort of looking forward to the stuff that's happening with D&D right now, aside from the job interview, which I'm very excited about, obviously. But aside from that, we're also doing some interesting things in D&D right now, which is super duper fun. So I believe I've talked about the match we have to throw. And we have had our first session with that, where we have also gotten to meet a friend of our DM's that said DM has talked about a lot. She's great. and is already, from what I'm aware of, because I am not the one who plays in that game, so when all Cinder System does, is a delight. and also adores cats almost as much as we do, which is saying something, because we adore cats a lot. Cats are amazing. They're spoiled little babies. so that's been fun. We're having another session of that because we just started combat. There's like 13 characters in play who have to take a turn in 2 hours. So, if it goes to pace as per usual, we're going to get through like one round per session, which is not a lot, but it does make for good, like, just a fun like hangout session when it's not your turn. Sort of mostly keeping track of that. There's also a lot going on, which has been very interesting for our brain. Like, extremely interesting. There we go. There we go. And we can... I will actually blend that really quick with a 5-level tool. There we go. And the blend is cleaned up. I've also been doing a lot of writing with my writing partner, which has been a lot of fun. Like, so much fun. Cosplay pants. Let me rename this one Henry costume jacket. There we go. Yeah, there we go. Now it's like properly labeled. And we have this properly labeled. All right. All right. So the D&D stuff is happening. In that regard, I've also been doing a lot of writing. There is other D&D stuff happening as well. We finally got another player for that game, which we've been kind of holding off on getting a fourth player for before we really did anything with it, because it did have to go on pause, did have to be paused due to personal differences. So I'm really excited to start actually getting, like, character sheets and stuff like that, and sort of leaning into some of that stuff, and doing more world building, and actually building out some of, like, where they're gonna start, because I am super excited. I've had like plot, I've had like a plot bait sort of sitting in my Discord, like my private Discord D&D chat for notes' sake, for at least a month, and I am super excited to finally sort of get a chance to actually like put it into play, maybe. Which I'm hoping is something that I get to do because I'm so excited. The group is like all queer, or most of us are all queer, like 2/3, 3/4 of the group. Like most of us using neo pronouns, which is even better, I think, sometimes, for me at least. Everyone there is like plural friendly, which is awesome because we're plural. And all of us have some stuff going on that make it like super doable. I'm really excited about this group because it's also a balance of people that like are new to us and people that are like that are comfort zone of like this person passes a vibe check, this person does or doesn't, especially when the group was previously had a lot of players that had personal disagreement. So this is really nice. Funnily enough, one of the things I did not think I was going to learn when I said, oh, I'm gonna DM a game, was to balance out where you're pulling players from. That is not something I thought I was gonna be learning when I made the decision. But in hindsight, it makes sense because it's a little bit like the phrase "don't put your eggs all in one basket." Don't, because if one negative thing happens with one friend, and they're all connected, that becomes a problem very easily. And unfortunately, that means it sort of spreads. That being said, definitely learned from that, which is always good. Just a little surprise in the things that you learn when you sort of pick up, like, the role of DM. But, this music is interesting. I know I've recently been watching videos of Forgotten City. Kirby and the Forgotten City. Which is what this is reminding me of. So it might be that. Or I might be overthinking, of course. Might just be inspired by that. Who knows? I like it, is the point. It's very pretty. Now, even when I finish the pants, I'm gonna have to finish the shoes probably as well, depending on where it's at. Oh boy, okay, that still might have been too light, but that's alright. Figure it out. There we go. We want to soften this up a little bit, because that is a very... I don't know, I probably could have made that like a thinner thing. Probably. There we go. Alright. Just... very good. It's a very good day, is what I'm discovering. So I hope all of you guys are having at least like half as good a day as I'm having, because... which I'm aware might sound... oh, dear. I'm overthinking myself again, as per usual. Don't mind me. I just hope you guys are having a good day, because I'm having a pretty good one too. Having a fun time. One of the things that, like, is giving me, like, a lot of sanity is painting. And the regularity with which, this is happening. One thing that will change if I do get this job is that I'm probably going to have to adjust my stream. I'm going to have to adjust my streaming schedule. And either stream less or stream at different times. But I will absolutely be trying to keep some streaming in here, because of A, I find this re-energizing, because I'm hanging out with you guys, I'm hanging out with people, and we're just hanging out, we're painting, arting, and talking together. Which is always nice and good for the brain to feel like you're having conversation. Our brain loves routine. And this is part of routine now. Because I've been streaming like this for at least a month and a half. Which may not seem like long to you, but I have the habit set. And I, like I said, enjoy my routine. And once it's there, it's a little bit comforting to know that there's that routine there. So I will absolutely, point being, be trying to keep some streaming in my schedule, no matter what happens. But I will be doing my best to, like, update you guys on Twitter, as to how things end up changing, in regard to streaming schedule. There we go. Let's see. Shoes. Okay. Henry costume. Shoes. Shading. Oh dear, I did not crack my neck today. Or my back. All this talk about self-care that I try to remind everyone to do, but here I am, being a bad example of it. Alright, I will absolutely be taking care of that later. Oh boy, I be feeling it. Okay. Well, let's set this at 75. There we go, we do that. Sort of round up that a little bit. Oh dear, I think that might be adding a little bit too much. 50. Let's see what happens if I set 50. There we go. Then it's not completely just like filling that in. Which is not what we want. Do not want that to be the case. Oh, we do not need that size either. There we go. This will do the job just fine. There we go. Alright. And let me clean this up. Oh, I know what song. I know what this one's from. I'd recognize Undertale music anywhere. Nothing wrong with Undertale. Undertale being super recognizable. Phantom can be questionable sometimes, but the game itself, incredible. Cannot, like, say enough good things about that game. Can we set this at 75? Just for the shape of the shoe, and then we'll clean that up afterwards. There we go. I just realized I'd never pulled this tab out, which could get distracting. Now that I've noticed that. There we go. Better. Right. Oh dear, no. Two. And then I will have the size of that tool to hop in here. And then I'll blend this. And then I'll clean up the inside if it gets in there. The inside of that tongue. We go, and then we clean this up as per usual. Then we are halfway done the costume, which is the last bit of this piece that I need to finish before this is done. And again, this is just not my best work, but it is also not terrible work either. Like, the dynamics of it is something that I'm still pretty dang proud of. There we go. I'm not gonna shade the undersides of the tongue. I don't think that's necessary. I think that does the job. All right. Now, if people briefly allow me to pull it up real quick. I'm gonna show you the thing I actually finished. Because the Venonat person, because that was actually like really well, something I'm really pleased with how it came out. I would like to, let me see. Image window capture. Yes, at source. Oh dear, okay. Let me close the window capture window cam. Okay. Image. Add a new source instead. Oh! Okay, no, now I know. Now I know what I'm doing. Apologies for that. Okay, yeah, let's add a new source instead. Source, and then browse. Okay, 2022. Go into the practice folder. There we go. This is what I recently finished. It zooms out a little bit more than this. It's actually pretty big. I am very pleased with how this came out. I tried to use all the varying colors of the spectrum, but the prompt was like a violet skin person with amber eyes, and then when I put on the hair, I realized, oh, no, I just made a Venonat as a human. Which was interesting. And not what I had been trying to do, but it looks really cool. And I tried to create the sort of galaxy background. Which is But yeah, it turned out really, really good, and this is what I worked on this weekend. So yeah, there's that. Let me get rid of that. Yes, I wanted to remove that. All right. Now we can hop back into the painting. I just need to take a brief momentary break from that. I'm actually going to be right back, but I will not be very long at all. I just need like one or 2 minutes. I'll be right back. All right, I am back. Wow, came back to interesting music, didn't I? All right. All right, I have stretched. I took care of my nose, so hopefully that should be better now. That should be better now. I hope that you took the time, if you could, to. Okay, outfit. Angel. Costume. Shading. I hope that you took the time to stretch at least, and maybe get some snacks while I was gone. I know I was not gone for very long, of course. but definitely good to try to sneak that in if you can. Now, this one is a lot more full body. So this one's going to be... Oh no, that needs to be... Let's see. Okay, no, that's good. That's the right shade. Okay. I wasn't sure. Now, the fun thing about this is that... the proportion... One of the things that I did not think to do was check the proportions on this. In canon, Angel is actually significantly smaller than Henry, but because of angle and such, you hardly notice that. There we go. There we go. Alright, and now we make sure that there's this. We're getting the shape of it. Alright, and then I'm also going to be doing the boots on a separate layer. Just to save a little bit of cleaning up and frustration. This Bug Fables. Oh no, it's Mario and Luigi. Which is not... even remotely like that. Now, Bug Fables is actually a pretty dang good game. That I wish I had access to. In a reasonable way, I mean. Because technically I do think that it is... I think it might be for the Switch, but I'm not 100% sure. And then let me set this opacity to 50. And then I will, no, that is not light enough, because it was a very light suit, so we are going to have to be mindful. We are actually putting lighting where it needs to be. Okay, so let me actually go to size 18 tool instead of 24. Just to make sure that we're actually getting everything. Now the fun thing about Angel, beyond the fact that like I know stuff about who Angel is as a person, although that is definitely fun, because there's Angel's very interesting as a being. Angel's physically stronger than Henry, despite him being like 6 foot something, I want to say. Somewhere between like 5 foot nine, 6 foot something. And I am not sure which. Oh dear, okay. Let's start blending, and I am also actually going to put another tool under this, another layer that is to say, under this, just to make sure that we are blending it well. Now, one of the things that you might have heard us mentioning, on the set, like, in the midst of random of rambling, are like us, we, system, plurality, that sort of thing. If you have questions about that, absolutely feel free to ask. This isn't exactly a secret that we try to hide. ERA system. And that is often not seen as much online. Most systems aren't exactly like comfortable putting themselves out there, which is entirely fair given the view people have on view people are like sort of taught to have, I think is a better way to say that, on us as plural people. Like a really shit representation, honestly. So it's very easy to understand why one might not know as much about what's happening with system stuff. Oh gosh, this music distracted myself. Okay, I'm gonna turn it down on my end. It will not be turned on for your end, don't worry. Sometimes you just gotta do that. Alright. So if you, out of curiosity, would like to mention that, would like to ask anything about that, feel free. There we go. Alright. And now, I'm going to... No, I'll just go around the whole body like this. That makes it a lot simpler. That makes it so much simpler. The boots and the... gloves will be a separate layer. I think. Do-do-do. Now, okay. There we go. Alright. Oh no. Okay. Went and got cocky. Okay. Now we're good. We're good now. Whew. Okay. I almost cleaned up into an area where the shading is supposed to be. Never what you want to do. Which I'm sure is a major shock. Sarcasm. Should clarify that, just in case. And then, let's... do that. Now we're going to be very, very careful about, like, where we put stuff. There we go, alright. I am thinking about this one time that I actually painted setting of Barovia. Or what I imagined to be the setting of Barovia based on the way that it had been described to me in a session before. And I think background wise that is the most complex piece I've ever sort of painted. Now I might think differently of that fairly shortly, but like at least at the moment nothing else comes to mind that goes anywhere near that level of difficulty. It was very, very fun to sort of paint that, paint my character, my character being like half of the painting, but like that was not the most challenge. That was not the most challenging part of it. The most challenging part of it was definitely the background of painting Barovia, like the church where I was going to sort of explain a little bit, but I don't know if any of you are ever going to play in it. I don't want to spoil the world for you. Something like I was given ample courtesy about without people even meaning to. Barovia is a very interesting setting if you are into that sort of gameplay of like dark and gloomy. I've seen like I've seen parodies based off of Welcome to the Internet, except like it's Welcome to Barovia, and it's very good. A lot of like I try not to. I had a favorite, and it's a little easier to appreciate the setting for what it is now that I'm not feeling literally personally attacked in the way that it was run. It's a very good setting, and it had a lot of lore that I really appreciated in the gameplay. I had like a lot of fun taking notes for that world. Very, very entertaining. No, but yeah, my point, if I may ramble back to it, of course, is Welcome to Barovia is a very common parody made for it off of Welcome to the Internet by Bo Burnham, and it's very, very good. When I first found it, I listened to it like once because I know that I don't process information very well. Plus, I wasn't expecting all that many spoilers in it. But what spoilers are in the parodies are often like very thinly touched upon and like very vague in that way. In that way that like you can still thoroughly enjoy it. And I, if you don't mind like vague spoilers that with like no details or anything about a world like that, I highly recommend you look it up. It is extremely good. I've thoroughly enjoyed all of the parodies that I've come across for it. And I think that others like there's a reason so many get made, because it's a very like fun sort of concept, as one will. It's like this whole other world tucked away. You can only access through certain channels. There we go. Okay, so that's cleaned up. That is cleaned up. All right. Gloves and boots. Shading. Okay. Hold on a moment. Wait a minute, just don't look at this. My brain's a little frazzled at the moment. There's a lot going on in my head. Seriously, but I mean, yeah, seriously, if you are ever in the neighborhood, as it were, in the community neighborhood to find some way to play Barovia, I highly recommend it. It's very, very fun. And very gratifying to like play through. And as your party like gets through to like see how you do it, how well you can stick together, because truly, like Barovia is not set to be your friend. Which I'm sure is shocking. but Barovia is not set to be your friend. Barovia is there to like tear you down. Really make you suffer. But it's so fun to play. In terms of like if you're into narrative shit, because it's so fun. It's very world built, it's very good. It's just so good about like the weight that things get given. And I thoroughly enjoyed it. I thoroughly enjoyed that part of the experience. That being said, don't be surprised if you run into vampires and they try to bite you know? It's Barovia, and it's fucking what's his name? I can't think of his full name, but he does have a name, like a full name. And he's not your friend, man. and he is there to cause you some major fucking suffering. And he does it in a very cruel, but like such compelling ways. I will not ruin that for you, of course. I thoroughly enjoyed the reveal of when I got kind of screwed over. I was told by my DM too at the time that like I would absolutely love the result of why of like what happened and why it happened. As a writer, that I would love it. And he was right. He was absolutely right. Story. This is like very much a story-driven place. Gosh, I can't say enough kind things about like Barovia. There we go. All right. Once we are done, the boots. That is actually it. For this, because then I can call it done. Because everything else is done. Just so we are aware. That being said, this may still take some time to actually shape. Don't you worry very much. Okay. Now I can actually. Okay, now actually, what I'm gonna do. And then pop that fucker in there with the 35 blending tool. No, that's too big a blending tool. 25 is not so bad. There we go. And this is a little bit more blended and a little bit more balanced, which I appreciate. Awesome. Now let's just clean up the edges. There shouldn't be too much cleanup to do. Gloves are pretty precise. Pretty dang precise about those. There we go. We go. All right, and now I go over to the other one. There we go. We go into 4. And then we put that little bit right here. And then we blend and blend again. There we go. All right. There we go. All right. All right, all right. There we go. Gloves done. Wait. Almost. Now I just zoomed out, but I noticed that little strip outside of that, and I'm like, that doesn't look right. Alright, now it's time to go out to the boots area. Let's go to this one. Oh dear. Okay. Oh, okay. Angel costume. Oh, but I can't because the boots are part of it. Okay, fine. All right. Now let's be a little more vibrantly. Oh, my posture's awful. Be better than me about that. Holy crap. You will thank yourself later on. Trust me. 75. And because this costume very specifically has like angelic sort of white gold sort of vibes, that is what we're leaning into at the moment. And then we will also be cleaning that up and then going into the wings later. This will be for the best, trust me. I'm saying that a lot, I know. Alright. Now this one I'm not going to worry about as much about. There we go. Alright, and then. There we go. Alright, and then we put a much lighter, like light gold going on in there. Borderline tan, admittedly, but it does the job. Debating on whether or not to get rid of those like lines as to where the side of the foot is, but I have not yet decided. Alright, for now, let's clean this shit up right here. And then can clean that up, which not that there's much to clean up there. Oh dear. Okay. Now we have to be careful. Oh dear. Okay. Now what I might do with that blending there is, oh no, did I do that by, I did that by accident. Okay. What I'll do is actually just do this. And then no pressure, more softness. Because this is already a sort of blended line. Oh no, I'm on the wrong layer. I thought that looked odd. Alright. No, oh dear, okay. Oh, softness, no pressure. We're trying to get rid of this line specifically. There we go. Now that's a lot lighter that you barely notice it. Awesome. And then we're gonna go over here now that we've actually put that shading in. Three swipes over at 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. There we go. And now, safe to blend. Safe to blend these shoes. Alright. Awesome. Looking good. Now we clean this up, and then we can actually worry about this little wing on the side. If you can see what I'm talking about. It's what I have the tool over right now. All right, so let's break up the five-sized tool, shall we? Oh dear. Oh no, that was not the eraser. Let's fix that. Okay. Pressure. No softness. Because I know we just did some line art. I forgot for a moment, somehow, that was the same tool. There we go. There we go. that my brain separated the function of what I was using it for, and it confused me. Now I do have a random question, and maybe there's an off chance that like you might have some sort of answer. So who knows? Why do principals need to go to school, like go to college, for principaling? Because as I understand it, you do. Like you need to go to like a principal college thing, and I don't understand why. All right. Let's get this. Put it at a different size tool. There we go. So now I'm going to now the other one is not going to have as much of like this sort of shading, but since it shows up under the thigh, we do get a little bit of it. And just the fact that it's like there, really. Just the fact that it's there. And then we go back over to where that shoe is. I'm going to go with a darker one at 50% opacity, just to make sure that we get the job done here. There we go. And what better song to sort of finish this with than an Undertale one. Thank you. Compilation that I've chosen for today's stream. You are ever so helpful. You are ever so helpful. And now, with that, we actually put the shading tool to an 8. And we blend, and we blend, and we blend. There we go. And what do we have here? But completely shaded painting. Now, admittedly, the stream is obviously not going to be as long. Let's make the signature layer, because there is no lighting to be done here. There's 100% opacity, and then I will, just for the sake of you can't, get rid of this. For rude ass art thieves, we're gonna do this, and let's save the painting once more. I'm going to export it, and then I think we're done for the day. So let's desktop art piece fan art of OCs. Is it really fan art though if it's your own characters? That is the question. And with that, let me get rid of all the windows so that we can size up the piece and you can get one full look at it. Was it an 80? To get a... Okay, 85. Oh, full size. There we go. There we go. And here is the final piece. What say ye? The walls are a little bit obnoxious for an actual person's house, but I thought that it would be fun. Playing with green is always super fun for me. Alright, So with that in mind, I'm actually going to. Boo. There we go. I'm actually going to end the stream here. So if you thank you for joining me, if you liked this, I will be uploading the I will be uploading this to YouTube as well, once I finish the stream. If you would like to see that is Clockwork System on YouTube. If you'd like to see some of my work actually shared on Instagram, that is Clockwork Sis on Instagram. And then if you would like to share anything that you might have made while I was streaming and painting, Clockwork_Sis, you can share that with me there. If, as always, I'm just going to let you know that if you would like a piece for yourself, my portfolio is linked theoretically on my Twitch and also on my Twitter, where the link is on our profile. So if you're interested, you can see a lot more of my much better work there, that I'm a lot more proud of. And I think that's it. So with that in mind, I hope that you enjoy the stream, that you've been taking care of yourself with snacks, drinks, and stretching your body.